Welcome. In this video, we will cover how to set up and print custom note cards in Photoshop Elements 11, 12, and 13 using your desktop inkjet printer and Red River Paper's line of pre-scored inkjet note cards. This tutorial is for Mac users. Some of the screens you see here may be slightly different than yours, but the workflow and steps are the same. Red River Paper offers free templates for use with Photoshop Elements on our website. Go to www.redriverpaper.com/templates. Click on the link and download the template zip file to your hard drive. Once the zip file is on your computer, you need to unzip or extract the contents. Double-click on the file. Once extracted, you will see a folder with the same name as the zipped file. Double-click to view its contents. The templates are broken up into folders by card size. Inside each folder, you will find two templates, one labeled horizontal and one vertical. Horizontal templates create cards that open like a table tent, while templates labeled vertical create cards that open like a book. Start by setting Photoshop Elements to expert mode. When you have selected and opened a template, you will see this note with some helpful reminders. Begin by locating the Layers palette. If you do not see the Layers palette, go to the Window menu and select Layers. Now go to the View menu and activate Rulers and Guides if they're not already visible. Click on the eyeball to turn the layer off, making it invisible. The blue guides around the edge of the card represent the printable margins on most inkjet printers. The middle guide represents where your card will fold. Now it's time to open an image for your card. Go to the File menu and choose Open, and then pick an image. The first step is to resize your photo based on the card size you are using. You will find an image sizing guide in the Written Card Setup tutorials on our website. I will set this card using a 7x10 size that folds to 5x7. In this case, I've chosen to use a 4x6 image on my card. Go to the Crop tool. Change the dimensions in this control panel to the size you want the image to become. Make certain you set the resolution to 300 pixels per inch, or PPI. This is important because the templates are all 300 PPI. If the resolution of the image and the template are different, the image will not fit properly onto the template. With the crop tool still active, click and drag your mouse across the image to capture as much of the file as you can. In some cases, you will lose some of the image due to its original size and proportions. Once you're satisfied, click on the green check mark to complete the crop. Your file has now been resized. Make sure the photo bin is active by clicking here. Double-click on the template file in the photo bin. This will activate that file in the editor. Now activate the Move tool in the toolbar menu here. You can also hit V on your keyboard. From the photo bin, click and drag your image up and onto the blank template, then release the mouse button. The image will now appear on the template as a new layer. As a layer, it can be freely moved about the template. You will place it onto the outside front panel of your template. Fine adjustments can be made with the layer active by tapping on the arrow keys on the keyboard. You can use the rulers for more precise adjustments. At this point, you could move on to the printing process. However, many customers like to put information about the image, a logo, or artist details on the back of the card template. You can open and add a logo file just like we did with the main image. You can also easily add text. Click on the Text tool or hit T on your keyboard. The Text tool will become active and you will see the tool's controls at the lower left. Set the font, size, and color, then click anywhere on the template. Type your message and click on the green check when complete. The text will appear as a new layer on the template. It can be moved with the Move tool and edited by clicking on it with the Text tool activated. Your layout is complete and you're now ready to print. Go to the File menu and choose Print. Start by verifying your printer is selected in the Select Printer drop-down here. Locate and click on Page Setup. Locate and click on the Paper Size drop-down. Scroll to the bottom and choose Manage Custom Sizes. In the Custom Paper Sizes dialog, locate and click on the plus button to create a new size. Double-click here and name the new size. Set the width to the smaller dimension of the paper you're using and the height to the larger dimension. Set all four margins to 0.2 inches. Making the margins smaller can cause an error that will prevent printing. When you're satisfied with the new size, click OK. Back at the print dialog, you will notice the paper size now reflects the new custom size. Click on the Layout drop-down and choose Printer Settings. Start with the media type. Set this based on the instructions that came with your paper or in the printer's profile download. Set print quality and any color mode as appropriate. Click Save and you're taken back to the Photoshop Elements print dialog. Select Paper Size should read Other and select Print Size, Custom. You can verify the print size by looking directly below the preview here. When you're satisfied with the setup, you can click Print, confident you'll get a great-looking greeting or note card.